It's a simple truth, a simple life. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, your mind. When it comes to loving everyone else, love your neighbor just like you love yourself.
Are you ready? I'm ready. Are you ready? I'm ready. Are you ready? Let's go!
You love me, this I know.
This I know.
Say my heart, never let it go.
Let it go.
I know I can follow you.
Follow you.
Yeah, I know I can follow you.
Come on, come on. Break it down now.
I'm spending time with
time
you.
With you.
Unconditional love, it's a two-in-one with our Father from up above. So we don't gotta worry, he will always be enough.
All we gotta do is follow you. All we gotta do is follow you. All we gotta do is follow you. All we gotta do is follow you.
One, two, three, come along with me.
Shepherds in
I loved worshiping with you guys. Now let's pray and get into our lesson. Dear Heavenly Father, I just thank you for these kids, and I thank you for these leaders who are so willing to teach your word to them. And I just pray that they feel your love and your presence and your peace that surpasses all understanding, and that wherever they are, whether they're here or at home, just wherever they are in life, that they feel you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Wow, this place is, messy.
Huh, you're right. Do you think we should clean up some?
Nah, Lissa's gone on her big captain conference thingamajig. I say we make the most of it and just relax.
That sounds amazing. Who really cares if it's a little messy around here? I mean, this is real. This is how people live. We shouldn't be ashamed if we haven't picked up.
Yeah, you know what? I think next week we should... Oh, remember how Connect Board told us that they were gonna start that new Connect HQ 2 team last week?
Yeah.
Well, they're gonna be visiting in 15 minutes.
What?
We are Connect HQ.
Every day we help the people of the world
live God's way.
We look for the links,
make the connection,
and you never know what might happen.
My name's Dot, and this is the time we learned how to find God's peace.
Oh, I think I hear them coming.
All right! My God, it's great to see you!
Oh my gosh, John, I didn't know you were gonna be a part of Connect HQ 2.
I just got the news! I am super excited to be a part of the HQ 2 team. This is Fiona. She's been a field officer for the last couple of years.
You're the field officer who helped Jaden when HQ shut down, right?
That's right. It was a pretty crazy day.
And who's this?
The name's Noam. Nice to meet you, Mike. And you too, Dot.
You look like you've got spunk, kid. I like you already.
Thanks so much for taking the time to meet with us, guys.
Yeah, the Connect Board sent us here so we could learn as much as we could from you before HQ2 opens in a few weeks.
Sean already knows the drill, but Fiona and I could use all the help we can get.
Oh, well, we don't mind showing you the ropes.
Come on, let's start with a tour.
Sure.
The Whatnot group was amazing.
I know!
And I love meeting the Quiet Time group, too. Everyone here has been so nice.
We are super proud of our team.
Hey, we got a new postcard.
A postcard? What do you mean?
Kids from all over the world send postcards to Connect HQ when they have questions they need answered.
And we have a really interesting question today. Riley from Raleigh wrote, "Dear Connect HQ, school hasn't been easy this year, and I've been feeling worried a lot. My grandma told me that I can find peace in Jesus, but I don't know how to do that. What can I do to find Jesus' peace?
That question seems kind of tough. I don't even know where to start.
We usually start with a point link, a verse link, and then a Bible link.
Let me see. A good point link for this week would be something like, healthy habits and prayer remind me that I've got God's gift of peace inside me.
Healthy habits and prayer remind me that I've got God's gift of peace inside me. Dad, I think that sounds perfect. How did you come up with that so fast?
I've learned a thing or two about healthy habits over the years. When I'm not feeling God's gift of perfect peace, there are things I can do to reconnect.
Dad, do you remember the pudding diet?
Oh, it took me weeks to get you guys back in shape.
What happened?
Well, now that we have all of the links, we should send a transmission to Dakota. Almost there. You do it, Vanessa.
I feel awful. You do it, Mike.
I have got such a bad case of pudding sweats. And my stomach is trying to kill me. Rodney, you do it.
I can't get up. I'll never be able to get up again.
Why do we all feel so terrible?
There must be some sort of bug going around.
What does John Paul, Paul John, say about feeling sick and not being able to move?
I didn't finish that chapter. I didn't have the strength to hold up the book anymore.
Guys, we need more pudding to get our strength up. Elaine, we need more pudding.
Elaine, pudding.
We need more pudding.
That's Chef Elaine. And eat a salad.
No thanks. But I will take some butterscotch pudding if you have that.
It's not on my diet.
Mike, will you eat the salad? It's good for you.
Oh, if you insist.
No, not like that.
Oh, I had to eat so much salad before I felt normal again.
When we don't take care of our bodies and practice self-care, that's one way we can get disconnected from God's peace.
Like if we don't exercise or get enough sleep?
Exactly.
Or eating too much of anything, like pudding. Okay.
Sometimes my little brother gets really worked up and hyper. By the time he runs out of energy, he usually feels pretty miserable.
Right, which is why it's so important for us to take care of our bodies in good ways. Like if you've been sitting for a while, take a break to walk or run or jump rope. And if you don't feel well, ask a grown-up for help and rest. And if you're hungry and thirsty, eat and drink healthy things. Those are all great ways you can practice self-care.
I get it. So does that mean we can answer Riley's postcard?
Not quite. There are other things that can disconnect us from God's peace.
Actually, this reminds me of something that Jake learned last year. It's Jake. He's getting angrier. I think we need to help him deal with what he's feeling before the sun goes down.
Tell me what happened.
Well, first he got a little snippy with Mike when Mike was goofing off earlier.
Well, Mike probably shouldn't have been goofing off.
Sure, but then he wasn't very nice to Maurice when Maurice nearly fell on top of him.
Well, I can see how that would scare Jake. Well, and he's just getting used to expressing his anger, you know?
Oatmeal raisin, my favorite. Oh. Chocolate chip? What sort of monster leaves chocolate chip cookies just laying around? Ew!
Jake had some trouble controlling his anger, but after he heard some godly advice, he learned healthy ways to deal with his feelings.
I think this banana might be a little too ripe. Do you have any others?
I can check. Is this another experiment?
I have no idea.
Well, I guess this gives me a chance to practice doing what's right, even when I feel angry.
Deep breath.
That's better.
So it sounds like our minds can get disconnected from God's peace too.
Most definitely. Thinking bad or angry thoughts over and over, ignoring how you feel or lying about it, or not asking for help when you need it are ways that your mind can leave you feeling worried and stressed.
So what can we do about it?
I'm so glad you asked.
Ooh.
First, we want to think about our thoughts. What are we thinking and experiencing? Then we want to think about our feelings. Are we feeling angry, jealous, or mean?
So you're saying once we know what we're thinking or feeling, then we can do something about it.
Exactly. Once we're mindful of our thoughts and our feelings, we want to talk to someone about it. Go to God first, but also tell a trusted friend or a family member. They can help us put healthy practices in a place, like breathing deeply, listening to worship music, and giving our thoughts and feelings to God.
Oh, I just thought of the perfect verse for this. Noel, do you want to say it with me?
Let's do it.
It comes from the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verses 6 through 7. Say it with me like this. Philippians 4, 6 through 7.
Philippians 4, 6 through 7.
Tell God about everything.
Tell God about everything.
Ask and pray and give thanks to Him.
Ask and pray and give thanks to Him.
Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds.
Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds.
When we take the time to pray and give thanks to God, He helps us to reconnect with His peace, and you can count on that.
So, we've talked about our minds and our bodies. Are there other ways we can get disconnected from God's peace?
I can think of one. Dot, how are you doing?
The answer can be found in the book of Dot, chapter 13, verse 2. Say with me like this. Dot can't think straight. She probably needs a nap.
Dot, Tony and I have something we want to say to you.
There are so many people to help, Alyssa, and I don't know all the answers.
None of us do, Dot, but God gives us what we need to know each week to help the kids that we need to.
Then why do I feel so hopeless?
Tony and I have noticed how hard you've been working and studying the Bible, but have you allowed God's word to feed your spirit?
Feed my spirit?
God's word doesn't exist just so that we can memorize it and have all the answers for people.
It's much more than that. It's meant to feed us, to help us grow spiritually, and to keep us healthy.
I guess I'd kind of forgotten about that. I've been so focused on studying the Bible to help others that I haven't taken the time to let God's word help me, too.
How are you feeling now?
Better, thanks. And I think you've helped me find an answer for Johnny. I'm gonna make a real connection transmission for him this time. And then I'm going to spend time reading my Bible.
So when we don't take care of our spirit, that can disconnect us from God's peace too?
Mm-hmm. I learned that the hard way. I got so focused on trying to help others that I stopped spending time with God.
And when we think we can do things on our own without God, we almost always just end up stressed out or worried.
In that case, what are the best ways to keep our spirit healthy?
First, follow Jesus as your best friend, Lord, and Savior.
Second, pray. You can pray anytime and no matter what you're doing. Ask God to remind you of His peace, thank Him for the good things He's done, and to help you trust in Him.
Third, read your Bible. Let God's word feed your spirit.
Thanks, guys. I want to remember every word you just said.
Me too. How can I make sure I don't forget?
Noel, let me introduce you to the best example you can follow.
This is the story about the God who loves us in the Bible. We find truth and purpose to love God and love others. We're searching God's word for things to discover. Is alive.
During Jesus' time on earth, He prayed a lot. He knew that prayer would keep Him close to God, His Father. Sometimes Jesus would pray with others, like when He asked Peter, James, and John to come with Him to a mountain to pray. Other times, Jesus would leave His disciples and pray by Himself so He would have time alone with His Father. When Jesus prayed, He prayed for all sorts of things. He prayed for His disciples, for those in need of healing, and for little children. Jesus even prayed for us and asked His Father to watch over us. That's right, Jesus prayed for you and for me. Through Jesus' prayers, we can learn how to pray too. Jesus used the Lord's Prayer to teach his disciples to pray. It wasn't long and fancy. He showed them that they could pray in a simple way about many different things. Our prayers can be the same way. Jesus also taught us that we should pray without giving up. God is always listening to what we say. The way he answers our prayers might be different from what we expect, but we can always trust his plan for us. So the next time you're happy or sad, or worried or angry, or just need help, talk to God about it. He listened to his son's prayers, and he'll listen to yours too.
Jesus knew how important it was to talk to God about everything, so he did all the time, and that helped him stay connected to his Father.
Nothing is too silly, horrible, big, or little for prayer. When we give everything to our Heavenly Father, we don't have to carry our burdens or worries anymore. He takes them and gives us his peace.
That's awesome.
I know. Thank you so much for showing us how to answer a postcard.
I can't wait to tell Riley what we learned. Can I tell Riley?
Yeah, go for it.
Hey, Riley, I'm Sean, and this is Fiona and Noel. We're all part of the Connect HQ2 team. We learned an awesome verse today, and I'd like to share it with you. It goes like this, Philippians 4, 6, and 7. Tell God about everything, ask him, pray, and give thanks to him. Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds. When you choose to follow Jesus, God's peace is with you. So if you're feeling worried, talk to God about what you're going through and be thankful. He'll help you find his peace.
Jesus, God's son, knew how important it was to talk to God about everything. His life shows us how nothing is too big or little for prayer. When we give everything to our Heavenly Father, he'll take our burdens and help us reconnect to his peace.
And prayer isn't the only thing we can do to find God's peace. When you feel like your body, mind, or spirit has disconnected from God's peace, try exercising and drinking water, thinking about your thoughts and feelings and talking to someone about them, and reading your Bible and listening to worship music.
No matter how worried or stressed you may be feeling, you can connect to the perfect peace that only God can give. Don't forget, healthy habits and prayer remind me that I've got God's gift of peace inside me. And remember, Connect HQ is here to help you.
Hey, God, what you doing?
Since there's going to be a second HQ team, we could have all kinds of team competitions. I'm thinking a softball league, a bowling league.
Oh, I love this idea.
Who can clap the fastest?
Who can run the fastest laps around HQ?
Hey, no, cheating.
Overly intense staring contest? No matter what you're going through, you can find peace through Jesus. And the first step to that peace is making Jesus your best friend, your Lord, and your Savior. Do you want to make that choice to follow Jesus today? All you have to remember are your ABCs.
A, admit. Admit that you've done wrong and ask God to forgive you for disobeying him. B, believe. Believe God sent Jesus to take the punishment for your sin. Trust that you are forgiven because Jesus made you right with God. C, choose. Choose to spend your whole life depending on God's power to help you say no to sin. As you live and love like Jesus, tell others God is your leader and number one friend. Did you make that choice today? If so, be sure to talk about it with a parent or a leader you trust.
Brightest.
together. This little light up.
Like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and subscribe to the YouTube at iHeartKidz.wv.